Queen of Pain.
Radiant team,
ladies and gentlemen, welcome back into the BTS Americas presented by Squarespace. Thank you so much for joining us. It is the semifinals of best of three series between two of the top teams in North America currently. Thank you so much for joining us. My name is Mott. I'm here alone today, believe it or not. The unfortunate reason why is that Dakota, Kyle Guy's internet is currently down. He's working on a solution. Hopefully he'll be here for game number two at the very least. Maybe if we go game number three as well, he'll be here for that one. So pray for his internet. I'm here solo currently, and that may change hopefully next game, but it is, of course, this best of three series, and I am alone for the time being. So again, my name is Mont. We're into the semifinals here for BTS Americas presented by Squarespace. Very excited to be bringing you this action. Champions of Summer's Rift going up against Complexity Gaming. As I mentioned, I think these are two of the top teams currently in North America. They're play has been absolutely outstanding. You go back to the TI5 qualifiers, and I don't think any team or any personality, any player really had Complexity pegged to take that top slot and make it to TI through the North American qualifiers, the American qualifiers. But nonetheless, they had a great time. They crushed the TI qualifiers. And I think a lot of that was, you know, their roster changes recently. Adding Ziz, which of course that happened a while ago. Fly, whose Rubick play has been absolutely outstanding. I mean, pretty much any hero that he plays, any support hero, has been absolutely fantastic. And then adding Moonmander back into the fray. So that's been something that I think has been really, really important for Complexity and how well they've been playing recently. On the other side of things, you have Champions of Summer's Rift, a team that is, I think, starting to hit their stride. They added IX Mike, they added Yuar. Yuar, of course, the brother of Sumail, and he's a top-tier player in his own right. And then, of course, having the core roster of Demon, Whitebeard, and Brax. Brax's play in the year 2014-2015 has been absolutely amazing. And so we'll see where they go from there. With that being said, we are going to jump into the draft. I do want to take a quick second to show the bracket because, again, we are in the semifinals. This is, of course, the best of three between Summer's Rift as well as Complexity. On the other side, you have Archon versus Root Gaming, which should also shape up to be quite the amazing series.
Dire team among picking.
And of course, that'll be tomorrow. Hopefully, with internet issues fixed, everything of that nature taken care of. Complexity start off their draft going with the Bounty Hunter, Queen of Pain, Darkseer. For Complexity, really, the great run they've had recently, I think a lot of that has to do with, again, I talked a lot about Fly and his support play, but pretty much getting whatever Swindle's comfortable with, which is usually either Lashrak, which they've picked in a numerous amount of games recently. Dragonite has been really important for them as well, for Swindle. And then, of course, Queen of Pain, which is the top mid hero of this patch. Pretty much loses to absolutely no one in lane. Can have a dominating performance and then snowball out of control. It's very difficult to deal with that hero early on in the game. You come for a gank at the Queen of Pain, you're expected to get results, and 9 times out of 10, you will. A hero that we don't see very often, however, is Darkseer. And which is actually kind of interesting. This hero, if you remember at the beginning of this patch, everyone picked this hero. It was picked in almost every tournament for good reason. Darkseer was crushing. And then people just realized, wow, Tusk is actually an amazing hero. And so Darkseer, Clockwork, even Centaur, Tidehunter, who's not particularly good right now, but still is an okay offlaner. Those heroes fell by the wayside. And suddenly, Tusk was the number one pickup. And the teams are realizing, oh shit, this hero is actually really good. We should ban him out from now on until the end of this draft, the end of this patch. So Tusk is not going to be played too much anymore, I think, as every team is realizing this hero is too good, and they'll get him out of the pool. Bounty Hunter is another one of those heroes that usually gets banned out. But Summer's Rift won't go for the Bounty Hunter ban. They instead try to maybe grab a Sentry for their mid laner, which at this point is looking like Alina. Naga Siren support with a Disruptor could go for like an aggro dual lane with another hero with a Naga Siren, which we see very often, could go for an aggro trial lane, although with Disruptor it's not that great. Anti-Mage has been very popular, but that's currently banned out by Summer's Rift. Maybe going for PL on the Dire side, we'll see what they go for. Complexity go for the Gyrocopter for Ziz, more than likely. So aggressive is the name of the game for Complexity. They want to be fighting, and they want to be fighting early. We'll see how that does pan out. Alright, looks like we're in. No big issues on my end so far. I do want to apologize. I kind of just got the setup a couple of minutes before we went live, so hopefully everything's looking good. The stream's looking good. It's not 60 FPS, unfortunately, but hopefully you guys enjoy it. As I said, some internet issues abound. last pick for Summer's Rift before the last ban phase. So like I said, Lina's probably going to be going mid. They could grab an offlaner or a safe laner here. I think PL is a good choice. It's pretty good against pretty much every single one of these heroes, maybe with the exception of Queen of Pain. Gyrocopter is pretty good against the PL as well, so I'm not sure if they do want to go for that late game kind of lineup. They go for the Clockwork first as their offlaner, and this is Mike's go-to hero. This is no surprise that they'll grab this hero. Mike has some questionable plays on many different heroes, but his Clockwork is above all solid. I've seen many games of IX Mike Clockwork, and he's been pretty modest about it too. He often thinks that even in games where he wins but doesn't perform the best, he thinks he's ass the hero. But his hookshots are fantastic. He's up there with the top of America's best Clockwork players, of course, with, you know, Bulba as well as Universe being the top two in my opinion. But they will grab that for him. He'll be heading to the offlane. He'll be against the Gyrocopter bounty character who will be roaming around, so he'll have an okay time, although Gyro gets close enough, Rocket Barrage is going to kill you, so Clockwork should have kind of a rough time. He won't be able to get a solo kill on the Gyrocopter. But get that level 6, start getting into fights. It is kind of hard to bring down the Queen of Pain with the Clockwork. That is one issue, is that it's really hard to lock this hero down, but that's why they have the Disruptor to have the Static Storm. Make sure she can't blink away when the Static Storm is dumped on her, and then have the Clockwork initiate. Clockwork can also lock down the Darkseer pretty well. Iron Shell will do a lot of damage, but Clockwork should be able to burst him down pretty effectively. Dragonite ban coming out on the side of Summer's Rift. They think this is going to be Queen of Pain safe lane and then grab something mid for Swindle Bounce, which is actually kind of interesting because they could do like Gyrocopter aggressive. That doesn't really make much sense. I'm not sure why they picked the DK or ban the DK.
Only 10 seconds.
On Complexity, they have one more pick left. We'll see what they go for.
5 seconds remain.
Rubick as their secondary support pickup. This is Fly's hero. You go back to the TI5 qualifiers. He stole Requiem. He stole pretty much every spell that was available to him, and he won a couple of games for his team on Rubick. Set up so many amazing kills. And I imagine Fly will be playing this one again. This leaves, I think, Z-Freak on the Bounty Hunter, Moonmander on the Darkseer, and that'll be Swindlemelon on the Queen of Pain mid lane. Summer's Rift, they have a last pick safe laner, more than likely. Unless this is an Aga Siren in a one position, which we very rarely see nowadays.
5 seconds.
Hurry!
Skyrath Mage is their secondary support. Both teams, no stranger to this hero. Z-Freak is, I think he still holds the record for kills on this hero. There's a slugfest in Dota 2 Canada Cup season like 4 or something. He was on this Skyrath Mage up against Sneaky Nyx Assassins. Z-Freak is not a stranger to playing against this hero, but it looks like it'll be Demon playing the Skyrath Mage this time around. And that'll lead us into the game. Game number one coming in. Of course, Champions of Summer's Rift versus Complexity of the Gaming. It is a best of three series, but it's single elimination. Whoever loses this best of three goes home. Whoever wins this one moves on to the grand finals to play up against either Archon or Root Gaming. Obviously very important. We're getting down to crunch time. Best of threes until we reach the grand finals. And then that grand finals is best of five for BTS Americas presented by Squarespace.
10 seconds to pick.
Just waiting on Demon to grab his hero, and then we'll jump into the game as soon as possible. There we go. Let me get rid of this draft overlay real quick. Boom! We are in, ladies and gentlemen. Complexity versus Summer's Rift.
Is everyone ready?
5-man aggression towards that top lane for Complexity. Orb of Venom start for Z-Freak on the Bounty Hunter. We've seen a lot of different play styles with the Bounty Hunter recently. Not today, most notably not going for the early Orb of Venom, but this is something we see on generally every Bounty Hunter support pickup, is that Orb of Venom. It's so good for harassing early on in the game. God, Ziz, can you not do that? Everyone's been spamming out this duo barrel roll bullshit, and it's just been super annoying, but Ziz continues to push my buttons. Moon will lead the way here for the Darkseer. On the other side, 5-man aggression into their own jungle, but leading the way out front is Yuar, who is going to be on that one position, Naga Siren. This is not something we see very often. Naga is pretty good early on for aggression. Riptide doing a decent chunk of damage. Then on top of that, you have the Skyrath Mage as well as the Disruptor. Should provide a lot of early game damage here if they decide to go for something like an aggro trilight. I don't believe they will.
Sports.
They will have the Swarming Bounty Hunter, might stay top for a bit with Moonmander, but it looks like for now they'll just rotate down towards that top rune spot, throw up an Observer Ward here, block this creep camp, get some vision as well, and go from there. And then on the other side, down bottom at the bottom rune spot already is Mike, and he's going to be holding off this bottom rune contention. It looks like top will go the way of Complexity. Rax is not skilled anything up yet. Everything's running in. There's Lock Heroes, Telekinesis, Shadow Strike, Rakdos is dead. And they even get the Bounty Rune as well. Did not see Z-Freak, obviously. He came right out of Invis early on, and he was not expecting that many heroes. But then Fly just hits an easy Telekinesis, and that's your first blood going the way of Complexity. So, interesting start. Fly will body block for Swindle Melons. Swindle already getting that. Who did pick up the first blood? It was Rubik. So that's a huge pickup for the support player from Complexity. Our top lane. Early Ring of Protection. He'll build that into an Akila more than likely. And Z-Freak is just being a nuisance. Is there a single Sentry Ward? They have one on Grax. They already threw out the Shadow Strike, and Whitebeard is going to have to back away. Meanwhile, Z-Freak will continue to rotate around. He has his own Sentry Ward with a Tango. This means that if Grax does place the Sentry down, they can walk in, throw up their own Sentry down, and just eat the Sentry with a Tango. We'll keep our eye on that mid lane as Z-Freak is roaming around, but we'll have to look at the other lanes as well and see how Mike's doing. Four last hits. He's actually having a great time. Jarcopter only sitting at one, so Ziz not having a particularly good start here. Complexity, I'm almost positive, boot camping. For Summer's Rift, I don't think so. There is that lane advantage coming out for Complexity. And I'm sure they're your favorites coming into the series. Z-Freak. Roman. Demon's gonna take a right click. Orb of Venom's gonna go. They even threw the Iron Shield to surge up as well. Demon is in trouble. Good concussive shot. Z-Freak actually in trouble. Riptide, they will get the kill in the end, but Z-Freak will trade his life away for it. Naga Siren does secure that kill, the return kill. Now rotating behind, Whitebeard maybe looking to throw up a glimpse on Moonmander, but they don't have enough damage yet, especially without Demon, to try to get this kill. Throw up the Thunderstrike first and foremost. Moon chasing him down. Iron Shield doing some work. Surge not. Oh, it is available, rather. Concussive shot will go. Riptide as well. They want Whitebeard, but the Ensnare goes through at the perfect time. They still will find Whitebeard. He doesn't go far enough away, and Moon does end up falling, but it is a support for a core trade in the end, and you are getting involved, but he's very low. Do they have a salve? Hold that thought. Z-Freak coming in. The Janata slow plus the Orb of Venom should be enough in that last range right click from Z-Freak on a Bounty Hunter secures the return kill again. Top lane's a goddamn bloodbath. Z-Freak secures that one. 13 last hits now for the Queen of Pain. And this is not unexpected. You see Quap in the mid lane. I don't care who she's going against. She should have an advantage early on, especially with what's been going on in terms of the laning and securing the early first blood.
Denied.
So he's having a pretty good time. Fly already has boots. And now Mike, who had a great start, is getting zoned out pretty effectively. He's level 3. What about Moonmander? He should probably be right there as well. In fact, he's level 4. So a lot of the trading is actually benefiting Moonmander. Roman on Brax. Shadow Strike first. LSA will hit, but here comes Z-Freak. The slow with Janata and Orb of Venom is ridiculous. Shroof and Toss will secure the kill. This should be an early level 6 for Z-Freak, but here comes the Concussive Shot. That shouldn't be enough damage. He'll stick up just to stay safe. An Arcane Ball on Swindle Melons. He's got Blink. He will eat up a tree, and he's going to use a Bottle Charge as well. And so Demon will try to go for the kill, but won't be successful in doing so. You are sitting at 14 last hits. Ziz sitting on 17. So a slow start turns into pretty decent pace here for the Gyrocopter. Rotation's mid. Brax back in the fray. Died twice already. 4 minutes into the game and has 14 last hits. They're going to have to make some space for him. Z-Freak is going to go ahead and just shadow walk up. Moonmander. This is going to get real obnoxious pretty soon for Summer's Rift. His Moon is going to start creep cutting if he's got enough room to do so. Z-Freak is going to find Demon, and Demon's going to have to use a concussive shot. It's just a lot of damage already from a level 3, level 4 Bounty Hunter. He even has an Invis rune if he needs to pop it. Brax is going to come nearby. He's getting ready to use his Light Strike Array. I don't want to use it yet. Iron Shell's still up. Demon's not going to get chased down. They have 3 heroes in this mid lane. Brax is actually rotated out of mid. Means he's not getting farmed. Instead, they're going to find him. LSA is going to connect the Z-Freak to the Iron Shell. Dragon Slayer goes through. He tried to bottle. Ancient Seal comes up, and there's the Ancient Rune. Last right click. Shadow Strike. He's bottling through, and Z-Freak will live. Hero Whitebeard might not be so lucky. Sal goes with the last right click. Swindle blinks all the way up towards the high ground. Gets a double kill. And 3 are dead on the ground for Summer's Rift. Complexity are already off to a fast start. Not to mention, Ziz has yet to rotate. He's still level 5, he's getting free farm. This is just with one Bounty Hunter and the occasional rotation in for Moonmander. They're finding easy picks. It's disastrous. Brax has died three times. Summer's Rift have got to find something to get a hold of. And Complexity are just making it look easy. And this doesn't lend itself to Yawar's late game plans. He's a Naga Siren. You don't want to be fighting until 25, 30 minutes into the game, and even that's a little bit early. Maybe they go for a new build on Naga, try to get some sort of early fighting. I guess if you do get an early Radiance, you could probably just jump in, throw up a song, get your team in a good position to team fight. Your Radiance burn damage should deal enough damage to these squishier heroes that it should be fine. But that's still a ways away. He's only 28 last hits. He's got 500 gold. He bought a bottle. He's going to buy an Aquila, and then he'll work on getting a Radiance. So Yawar is still not anywhere near this either. And that's the difference between something like a Gyrocopter and an Naga Siren is that Gyro hits level 6 and he's like, I'm out of here. See you later. I'm going top. And probably throws down a call down and finds a kill. He's level 6 now. He'll find Brax. There's a regen rune at the bottom rune spot. Brax will finally secure a rune for himself. Doesn't have boots yet, by the way. Still not level 6. So the Gyrocopter and the Safeflynn already level 6, whereas Lina, not even close. The rotation's top from Z-Freak. They do have a Sentry Ward here. Sugoi Me. That's a great name. Whitebeard. Z-Freak now out of the Sentry range, but Whitebeard, I'm sure, is spotting close by, and they'll sit underneath the tower and try to stay safe. Whereas bottom lane, Fly sitting underneath that Observer Ward, which is really well placed. Brax still has that regen rune. Now he's going to have his level 6 ready to go with the Laguna Blade. Fly, no points into the null field just yet. On the backside, Demon here might. No usage of that hookshot, but goddamn, it's going to blow up fast. Ancient Seal plus the Dragon Slave and LSA is more than enough to blow up that poor Rubick. It's not the highest value target in the world for Summer's Rift, but at least they get a kill. They're making some space for Yuar. Same ward placement for Z-Freak as it was previously. We'll see Yuar grabbing the courier, Aquila now done, and now we see the Radiance build begin, I would imagine. Look at this. Look at this cheeky play. He knows the bottle curry is coming. He's got the Janata ready. Dear lord. This courier's dead, I'm pretty sure. They have no speed boost. Z-Freak is waiting for it clearly. Throws up. Yeah, that's dead courier. That's bottled down as well. Say goodbye to Yawar's farm. That's a huge pickup. Z-Freak with a nice courier kill. Bottom tower They're just making it so difficult at every turn for Summer's Rift. They can't grab a hold of anything, either through kills, either through CS, either through rotations. Certainly no towers have been taken yet, and now they rotate Radiance three heroes up top, including Fly. Fire. And on the way is an Invis Swindle Mounds, which they did not see. There's no Observer Ward at the top rune spot for Summer's Rift. And they're looking to make a jump in. Easy dive. Z-Freak will cut the creeper with a dying shell. Decides against it. Swindle Mounds still getting ready to go. They'll find a couple of illusions. Yuar. The tree line. They do see the Gander. Now Z-Freak looking. They saw him go for Yuar. They're getting ready. Whitebeard in trouble. Kinetic Field misses. Doesn't have a Static Storm. Here comes Ike Smite. Call down's gonna go. Scissors rotated in. They blow up one. But huge cogs. LSA Fly. Not dead yet. Walls on the ground. They hit the Dragonson. Here comes Swindle. There's the Sonic Wave. Laguna gets fused. Swindle out of mana. Hookshot from Mike. He just got it. Now Swindle in trouble. Blink up in 8 seconds. Grabs the kill with a Scream of Pain. Yuar out of mana. Now they're chasing after Brax. Three dead of the dirt. Two for Complexity. Brax in trouble. Shadow Strike taking him down. LSA will not connect. He's just trying to get further and deeper into the tree line. Buys his treads and Ziz will clean him up with a rocket barrage. It does turn into a 3-for-2. At least Summer's Rift gets something to hang their hat on. Complexity again. They find the gold advantage and they'll secure a tier 1 tower more than likely. Glyph will get popped. Pretty big engagement. Actually, 2-for-4 in the end. Brax does survive at the very least, which is fine. They lose two supports. Yuar survives. He doesn't need anything out of that except for a little bit of experience. Could have been worse for Summer's Rift, I guess is how you'd put it.
Dire's top tower is being attacked.
Smoke of Deceit. Now Mike level 8. Hookshot on cooldown for 8 seconds. Moonbander might get silenced up here. He will. Gust of Shot's going to Fly. Need to get that battery assault off. Good body blocks from Demon. Now they get the Kaz. The Surge is not there in time, and Moon is done, so Mike will secure the kill. More than likely. It's actually Demon getting that last right quick, but a gank's a gank, and they get one done. The light game is there for Summer's Rift. Yawar has been able to pull out games like this before. But Track is online now. There is a level 7 bounty hunter. He throws up another aggressive observer ward behind the tier 1 tower mid and in front of the tier 2 tower. I see you are. Doesn't have song yet for another 60 seconds. He's only level 1. In fact, he's only level 7. Not the most experience coming up for an Oxar in that safe lane. Got plenty of farm. The creep waves were constantly under his tower at the very least, so he was able to get some CS, but still without his bottle. Meanwhile, Z-Freak is right next to UR. Riptide goes, doesn't connect. Mike and Newman are going to the battle so has a shot. Mike, maybe in trouble. The Iron Shell doing some work. There's the kinetic field. Stick charge. Mike sticks himself up as well. That was a lot closer than it probably should have been. A little advice. And Z-Freak is, I just think, waiting for this courier again. But this time, UR does have his bottle back on his person and goes for the early arcanes as well. This is something we see Envy do a lot when he's playing the Naga Siren. But this does mean that he will not be getting that radiance until 22 to 25 minutes, maybe even later, depending on how the game goes. Swindle goes for a casual bracer, might build that into a drum. See if he goes for that early Orchid or early Aghanim Scepter, maybe just picks up the drums instead. They're rotating top, they're looking to try to find a gank fly with the telekinesis at the ready. No spell steal yet, but he's close to it. One creep wave and he's got it. That is a very early time blade mail for Clockwork. Mike's had a great game. 4 assists, 1 kill, 5 kill involvement. Pretty special so far. D ward from Whitebeard on that observer. Well done. Not sure how they knew that was there, but that's a pretty important D ward. You look at the vision now. There is still some good vision coming out on the side of Complexity. Summer's Rift, they've got something down bottom, but that's it, really. No real vision in mid, no real vision top lane, top rune spot. They've got nothing going for them.
Radiant's bottom tower is being attacked.
What's that? Dragon Slave? Pretty good spell to steal. It's no Laguna, but sometimes that's for the better when you're a Rubick. They're going to try to push this tier 1 tower for now. They'll back away. They still have that wave and, or rather, wall of replica.
Dire's top tower
Vacuum
is under
level
siege.
2, so he's getting ready to fight. No mech. He goes for the early cloak, so might just be going for a casual glimmer cape. Anybody building mech on their side? No. Drum's done for Ziz. What's UR sitting at?
Dire's top
gold?
Tower
right.
Is being attacked.
Uh-oh. Hookshot, Mike's going to find a huge kill. That's going to be on Ziz. Here comes the side of Swindle. Sonic Wave doesn't blow up Mike yet. Dragon Slave, Laguna goes. Swindle, now the wall replica glimpse back in. Static Storm, that'll secure the kill on Swindle. But here comes Z-Freak and Moonheater. They'll turn it into a 2-for-2. A couple of those were track kills, I believe. Although they do bring down two of the most, if not the most important heroes on Complexity. They only lose the Lina Fort and, of course, the support Disruptor. But if you look at the gold exchange, still very even with track up. Still very even. That does mean more space created for Naga Siren, who's now up to 1,200 gold.
Dire's middle tower is being attacked.
And Fly is just sitting bottom, says, yeah, I'll take some room. Give me some of those creeps, it's fine. Get on that Yule Scepter, Brax. That's a free kill if he can finish that up. Z-Freak's nearby, level 8 on him.
Dire's middle tower taking
been about
damage.
Throwing out the track. They have a great observer ward that's being countered again by Whitebeard. He throws sentries all over the place just to keep his own jungle safe. And that's the problem right now for Yawar, is just he doesn't have anywhere to farm, really. He has to head bottom. That's the safest place for him to farm at this point in the game. Can't farm his own jungle, that's for damn sure. Especially not if this tier 1 tower dies mid. Pretty big access point for Summer's Rift into their own jungle. They have to take control of their own jungle back if they want UR to really flourish in this game. It's just, it doesn't seem possible now with how much aggression's being dumped on them. Zeus gonna get caught out again. Hooks up Mike's mic to have Buddha Blade up, and that'll secure the kill. That's another huge pick. Early Yule Scepter now picked up for the Queen of Pain. Rotation bottom from Z-Freak. No detection here. They have to actually Sentries on Demon. They have a smoke as well. They need it.
Radiant's bottom tower is being attacked.
And now they're going to take the opposing T1 tower. TP not coming through from Complexity to defend this. They'll glyph it up, but this is assuredly dead.
Under fire.
And Yuar will pick up the last hit. 2200 gold. One static storm swindle in trouble. Beautiful play from Wayne from there. Yep, Light Striker right, Swindle, donezo. Big glimpse, level 4 glimpse. You can never count it out. Even if you're Queen of Pain, that Thunderstrike comes up and boom, you're donezo. And suddenly, look at this. Top 4 of net worth. 3 are on the side of Summer's Rift. However, this will change. Complexity to take down this tier 1 tower. Summer's Rift are fighting back. They're gaining control of their own jungle. Yuar is gaining control of the enemy jungle. He gets a Radiant. This game starts getting out of hand real quick. And Ziz is actually having trouble finding areas to farm. You look at his CS currently, and he's started to lag behind that of the Naga Siren. It's only going to get worse as the game progresses. Brax is going to get caught up by Z-Freak. Shurikatos goes with the urn on him, but with treads, Brax is pretty tanky, so he's not too worried about it. He also had 7 wand charges, so he actually needed to fly to rotate a bit earlier, but he wasn't there in time. The moving ward that is Z-Freak is providing them plenty of vision. And if you look at the vision, there is one observer ward here. Oh, God. You are, buddy. That's just not great. He walks right into its sonic wave. Smoke and see Mike looking for a hookshot target. Scepter comes through, vacuum wall, beautifully done from Moon. Now they have a great use of that Mystic Flare, but now they have to finish him off. Wall's still doing a lot of work. Brax actually has to back away. Mike still wants to keep going, but now heading out, looking for a TP. Vacuum not up and ready to go, so Mike is going to get away, and they find yet another kill on that gyrocopter. Off to defense top, they're going to rotate quickly as Fly. Well, it's just Fly, never mind. They don't really care that much. They just want to get some farm. Yeah, we're back into the fray. 2.6k gold in the bank. Still trying to hit that timing.
Being attacked.
Comes back onto Fly. He was staying in this position for a good couple of seconds here. Spell was stolen. That's a big steal for Fly. Meanwhile, Swindle Melons links up in one. They have the Ancient Seal, but of course, the usage of that Yule Scepter will get it off. Yule's is still up. Song will go first. Mike will probably go for battle, so they have looked up. They use the Static Storm instead. Yule's good going. We'll keep him alive for the time being, but that means that Ancient Seal will be used. And grab this kill, but the Ensnare is up now, and we'll right click to do the job. Not to get things back, but they will secure it. Great. He's going to call it out, but no real follow-up damage there. And they lose Swindle again. Hookshot catches it. It's a Mystic Flare with the cogs. The classic combo. Ancient Seal just rounded out, and Demon gets a double kill. Demon going to work. 3 dead on the map. You look at Z-Freak, wasn't anywhere near that engagement. Fly, just pushing top. Summer's Rift getting back on their feet, knocking out to 3.3k.
Rack it on.
It's happening. That's all I can say, clearly it's happening. Summer's Rift are in a prime position. They tied up the kill score 15-15. They were getting decimated early on in this game. Glyph will go in that tier 1 tower in the mid lane, but top is where Complexity are rotating towards. We'll lose that tier 1 mid for Yawar. Doesn't pick up the last hit, but still gets the gold anyways. Obviously, getting the team gold is fine. You have to wonder what Brax is going to go for next. Z-Freak has been stifled at his next item. Guardian Greaves. Oh, God. Walks right into his Sentry Ward. That might have just been the tail edge of it. Hookshot connects. Mike's going to find a target. It's going to be Fly. And we'll come some back. Yule Scepter is going to go through. He tries to set up the LC. He's going to hit it. Dragon Slave will fly. A couple more right clicks. That'll secure the kill. Double kill for Brax, who's dominating, by the way. So, Summer's Rift go to the enemy jungle, and they've done this about 3 or 4 times now. They don't find a single kill, they lose a couple of heroes, and their item progression is stifled. What once was a great lead for them now is turned into nothing at items. They've had these drums for Gyrocopter for a long time, in the bank or in a stash. Moonmander is working on a 4 staff now at the very least, but he's not really been involved that much. Swindle's trying to get towards a Staff of Wizardry for whatever item he picks up. On the other side of things, Summer's Rift are starting to get their items. Radiance is coming. Jump in, Static Storm, Swinemon still does have that Heal Scepter, doesn't want to use it yet. Ancient Seal might go, they will use it just the right time. He heals himself, but he just was out of time, honestly. He didn't have any real way to use that without dying. So they will pick up the kill. And another pick off on, once was the, I think, most farmed hero in the game, is now sitting third in net worth. So what are we looking at here in terms of itemization? 4 Seth already, plus a point booster from Mike. He's freaking rich on his clockwork, man. That's something else. Whitebeard already has 2 components of his Aghanim Scepter. Brax is working on, I would imagine, an Aghanim Scepter for himself. And then, of course, you are building towards that Naga Siren Radiance. And then we already talked about the stifled itemization of complexity. This game is really on Ziz, but he's just not finding the farm. He's gotten ganked multiple times. He's sitting underneath a ward here on the side of Summer's Rift, and he's gonna walk deeper into the jungle. And if Mike finds him, it's a dead hero. He's even TPing top looking for this hookshot. The range isn't that long, it is level 2, but Mike should be able to find this. They've got the glimpse, Thunderstrike will go first, and Ziz knows he's double kinetic, it's gonna fly. Call down's gonna go, and that's only gonna hurt him more. It's Mike pops Blade Mail. He's dominating. Filthy rich clockwork at this point. UR is like, you guys couldn't have waited for me. UR has actually had, he's got his radiance at 21 minutes. So let me break this down for you. He went Arcanes, Bottle, Aquila, and has his radiance at 21 minutes. Pretty good timing when you consider that he was getting ganked and roamed on pretty heavily. This game just got a lot easier for Summer's Rift. Got a lot harder for complexity.
It goes!
Ooh, the smoke fly. He flags Mike. They do bring the high ground. You can see on the fly. But shot that just destroys him. Vacuum all, but only up to one. LSA on the 2. Moonmander taking the brunt of the Mystic Flare. Swindle still jumping in. Cogs can go trying to push them back. Mike takes a Shuriken Toss. They're going to Swindle Mount. Still has that Sonic Wave. Mike has his Blade Mail in 1. Sonic Wave goes before that. Mike still alive. Last right click, and that's a track kill. They needed something, and boy, did they find it. And that will provide the mech now, and they can continue up here and look for these kills. But already backing away Summer's Rift, they'll make it towards their own base. 3.4k for Brax, by the way. Still deciding what item he wants to pick up. And finally, Complexity gets something that they can use. They pick up a kill, and now they'll grab a tier 1 tower bottom for the Queen of Pain after getting that track kill, which provides her up to 2.6k in gold.
Dire's bottom tower is being attacked.
How do they deal with whatever Summer's Rift have? Mike is actually just decimating their entire lineup. He's going to go for the Aghanim Scepter. They want to fight, and they want to bring him down early on. Problem is, he's getting silenced almost every single engagement. So he has to either time his Yules the right way, or be the one to initiate, or buy a BKB, and then he doesn't have to worry about any of that. Assuming there's no Aghanim Scepter for the Disruptor, which is a bold assumption at this point, considering how this game's going. Not to mention, Demon getting an Atos is going to be pretty fantastic, but he's not anywhere close to that. He only has a casual Vitality booster for now. Ziz is working on his BKB. He gets that item, and suddenly this game gets a bit easier. He'll still get locked into place with a hookshot or an ensnare, obviously, but there's not much right-click yet for Summer's Rift. And of course, UR is going to be the main facilitator of that later on down the road, but he's not at that point. And Aghanim Scepter is now done after that one kill. Complexity should feel pretty comfortable now, but however, Z-Freak might get caught. They don't have the vision. Spell stolen. Flies gonna get blocked back. There's the status room. Doesn't connect. Flies able to walk out of an Ancient Seal. He actually gets Boomer Chase. I think that's by Moonmander. TP coming through, but no. Swindle takes some hero. Whitebeard should be dead here. No problem. TP from Demon. He'll make it out, but they do end up losing one particular hero. Mike is actually still tracked up. They won't be able to chase him down, but now Complexity finding their feet as you are still not able to really fight. It's only 24 minutes in the game.
Under siege. Dire's top tower has been denied. Bastards.
There it is. He's been holding on to his money for so long, I was wondering what he'd be buying. He's very close to level 16, and at that point, 950 pure damage will blow up just about anybody. There are some tanky heroes. You get one right click and Z-Freak's dead, essentially. And a couple, maybe a Dragon Slave on Darkseer, he'll fall quickly, and then obviously Fly is gonna get one shot, no issues there. But Swindle and Z-Freak, or rather Swindle and Ziz, are the two biggest issues. Some casual low ground farming. I like it. No roaches have been taken yet. 25 minutes in. Neither team has a particularly good roaching lineup, to be fair. Plug City a little bit easier for them than I think for Summer's Rift. There is some right click coming out from Brax with his Fiery Soul, but Yawar is just not there yet. Puts down his energy booster now, or rather he disassembles his arcane boots and grabs on the energy booster as a casual pick-me-up. And he has his boots of travel. And they're going to start splitting the map up. So I think Summer's Rift are okay with losing a couple heroes or losing a couple of trades here or there, as long as they're not losing their entire lineup. And as long as Yawar is farming. That's, I think, the most important thing. Him dying is pretty devastating at this point. Complexity, they want to put the pressure on, though. They know they have this really good advantage. LSA is not going to connect. Brax will back away. It's going to get Shrooka tossed, so he heals himself up first. Swindle has his ready to go if necessary. Blink in. Decides against it. Hero, Whitebeard, King comes him back. They wanted to. Decided. He will go for it. Static Storm on the deck. And now Laguna comes through. Dragon Slate. Glimmer Cape will not save him. He's getting too aggressive there. Now the hookshot Z-Freak gets forced away out of the Mystic Flare. Well played there. Coming from Fly. Backing wall, but it's a bit too late coming on Complexity's side. Call down just to zone them out and Fly. Hightailing it out of there. Glimpse back in one. They have got the flare. They've gotten the vision. They'll bring it back in. Medical doesn't connect. They don't need it. Battle Assault going in. They've got Cogs in 1 second. Force, and they grab and Fly. No Force Staff for himself. Blade Mail goes in. Ancient Seal. Dunzo. Demon dominating yet again. Three down for Complexity. All the meanwhile, they find a Song Target. Trying to get out of there. Though Yules himself. I think that might have been Brax's Yules, actually. And they grab the kill with a Light Strike Ray. That's 4 for nothing. They didn't get anything for Complexity. And Summer's Rift taking it to them right now. 2,000 gold for Yawar. How much money did they gain? All right. Fight recap. Good work there, buddy. Look at this net worth. They had a 5,000 net worth lead at one point for Complexity. This is with a Bounty Hunter with Track. And Summer's Rift making it look easy now, 27 minutes into the game. Casual Sonic Wave, blow up Creep Wave. Only 40 second cooldown, why not? I think Swindle Melons really needs BKB. I'm gonna be honest with you. Ziz is already on the way towards his, and that's fine. But Swindle's really the frontliner. He wants to be up and close, and he wants to be able to blow these heroes up rather quickly, and he's just not doing that. He's been caught too many times. This disruptor pickup for Whitebeard has been outstanding. Really on point. PKB now done for the gyrocopter. Blink on the other side for Brax. Yeah, a BKB for Swindle would go a mile. Z-Freak. Hook shot. We'll find Swindle Melons. Cock push there. They need a Static Storm. They need Eclipse now. They'll find it. Static Storm might be coming on the backside. He's got no blink for two. There's a Sonic Wave. This is pretty short cooldown. On the other side, Z-Freak was looking to back around and try to find a flank, but can't actually find one. They don't know that he's there. Tracks up. Now they know he's there. Do they have detection is the real question. Oh, kinetic field. They know exactly where he is. Dust does catch Z-Freak. He's going to try to TP away. Battery Assault will not grab him. Mike not close enough to hit it. Good try there. Summer's Rift might have to invest in a gem here at some point in the near future. But they're just starting to get on their feet in terms of their own itemization. And oh, Whitebeard's so close to the Aghanim Scepter. Same could be said for Mike as well. Demon almost getting up his Rod of Atos. Already a Yasha for Yawar. I don't know what else to say. This is trouble for Complexity. The thing is, Moonmander has been hitting these amazing vacuum walls. But his team's usually dead or not fighting at that period of time. So it doesn't matter how you hit them. Your team needs to be alive. But if they can have everyone alive for Complexity, hit a big wall vacuum, call down, Sonic Wave, they have the team fight to take this game. There are no BKBs on the map for Summer's Rift. Yeah, they are pretty tanky throughout the regular items that they have. But there's a definite possibility that they can take a team fight if Summer's Rift botches it.
With flair.
And now Yawar posturing around Roche. And he's going to get his Octarine Core next as well. He's pretty much got it, with the exception of the Mystic Staff, and he's not that far away from it, considering how quickly he farms. YOLO Smoke Gank from Complexity into their own jungle. They have vision of a couple of heroes. Mike and Demon clearly visible. Hero might not be. They're gonna walk in. Cannon Wall on into the easy composition. So Laguna Blade blows him up. Sonic Waves is not dead yet. Nor is Brack. Talks to the Haste Rune. He's pretty quick. Shadow Strike won't slow him down. Song's gonna reset the fight at will. Yule Scepter from Swiddle to catch Brax out. Brax needs to regen. They might just leave altogether. Well, they'll try to. I'm not sure if they'll make it away. Yule Scepter avoids the Shadow Strike, but Brax is about to die here. Blinks away at a beautiful time. LSA to just try to get through the trees a bit further. They might not pick up a single kill here for Complexity. That would be disastrous. Can't find a single hero. Are you kidding me? Great engagement. They can't find anybody. That's a vacuum wall expended. Call down. Use Sonic Wave. Use nothing. Can't find a single goddamn thing in the map. That's got to be super frustrating if you're Complexity. So close. So close to at least one hero there. Yuar comes in with a great song of the siren to counteract it. And Octarine gets closer and closer. 1,000 gold away for Yuar, and he should be able to grab that in no time flat. They're going to try and fly. Dual Scepter, LSA is going to go, but Mystic Flare was, or rather, ATC is still on. That's a shot. Z3 doesn't have to TKB up for 5 seconds. Where do people go? Now he'll shut in to fly. That's going to secure the ship more than likely, but they want Ziz. They might get this back. BKB, there's the Laguna, though. Blows him up while TPing away, and Brax will secure the double kill for himself. And now they have complete map control. They've got time to Roche, and that seems to be what they're going to go for. Mike will finally finish up Zagatim Scepter, and as if the game wasn't hard enough, they're also going to have, probably after this Roche release very soon, White Spirit having his own Zagatim Scepter. And if they just can get one team fight with like three track kills in that team fight, they'd be probably back in the game. They just can't grab that team fight, though. They had a chance at that bottom engagement. There it is. There's one Aghanim Scepter. Octarine now done. They pick up a gem coming out for the Darkseer, so they really want some vision. That Whitebeard. 50 gold away. And he's got it. He's going to walk home and he'll have his Aghanim Scepter. Forget your gamey now. If they find you before that, you're donezo. Game is going to try to. I think Summer's Rift are going to pick up the pace and trying to finish this game off here in the next, 10, 15 minutes, if they can.
Dire's middle tower taking damage.
Complexity there, just thinking, well, what do we do here in this situation? Swiddle building towards either Octarine or, of course, the big old Scythe device. Both are fine items. Or Sheep's Guard, by the way, too, could work, but I think it's probably a Scythe. Soon. They have to have some extra lockdown because Summer's Rift are clearly very slippery. Oh boy, this doesn't look good. Fly already knows. Fly TP's away. And Z-Freak's like, I'm out of here. Hookshot misses. Yuar does have a gem on him, by the way. So gem on either side. Guardian Greaves now done, so that's a pretty big item for Z-Freak.
Regeneration!
Time to group up. Smoke a deceit. Smoke and a counter smoke. They've drawn the line. They know there is a ward there. They do not want to deward it. Fly pings just saying, listen, they might be nearby. But as it stands right now, they just might probably pass by each other like two ships in the night. Ooh, they're going for the complete wraparound on the side of Summer's Rift. Instead, they back up. They got a good idea of where they are. Song will start things off, and Brax is going to get ready to go with an LSA and Swoonamelon. Static Storm first and foremost. No BKB, no yields available now, and he's just done. Swoonamelon control first. No Guarding groups to keep him alive. Meanwhile, they take down Demon Mike. He's going to work a Moonmander. Vacuum Ball onto Mike, then forces himself out. Moon's so low. Booms back in. I don't know what happened there. He pulls away. Hookshot will secure the kill. Yules now will find Ziggs. Up in the air, LSA, Rocket Prize going, but it's just not enough, and he's done. 4-for-1 exchange. Demon more than happy with how that turned out. And now Yawara's going to TP bottom, put some pressure on the Tier 2 while the rest of his team heads to the top Tier 2 tower, split pushes it up and goes to work. It's just not looking great for Complexity. And they still have the Aegis as well for Brax.
Radiant's bottom tower is being attacked.
Yawara will grab the first Tier 2.
Radiant's
Brax
bottom
will clear up the creep wave top lane. Our heroes that are respawning here demolished. In just a moment, but... Brax working on this. Bot's up in right now, actually. Or could TP top if he wanted to, but he's going to let Brax do all the grunt work. He might not be able to grab this 2-2 tower. They can glyph this, I think, and it'll stay alive.
Radiant have fortified.
Yeah, there's the glyph,
towers.
And he blinks himself away. They'll deny it. Either way, they take 2 tier 2 towers off the back end of a huge team fight. That's going to give them a 7,500, almost 10k gold advantage. With the Naga Siren on their team, mind
Bastards.
You. Almost 10k experience advantage. Now you're just going for luxury items for Mike. I mean, you have a Force, you have a Blade Mail, you have an Aghanim Scepter. What's your next item? What do you, you know, realistically go for?
And it's off!
Manta now done for the Naga Siren, so... casual, standard Naga Siren progression. And on the other side, Complexity are just trying to find whatever they can. Map control is starting to dwindle. It's a pretty big far cry from what we saw earlier on in the game when they had the entire map control. No. There, the jungle was taking control pretty effectively by Complexity.
Radiant's middle tower is
Bloodstone
taking
Brax.
Damage.
That's an impossibility. Octarine's also a card he wants to go for. Maybe a little bit. Got some decent regen. Blinks up to the tier 3 tower. It's been aggressive. There's no tier 2s left. Buyback status, what's it looking like? They only have the Queen of Pain buyback available. They want to finish this now. Brax does not have his Aegis anymore. No, he still does. He's going to get reclaimed now, so spoke a bit too soon. Riptide equipped with creep waves and anyone that's nearby. But the Naga Siren is just going to work. They're going to find Z-Free. Yuz will go through. Good guarding Greaves, but he's done. He does get one track off, and it's Janata proc before dying. But I mean, he can't do anything. He's just too far out. The gem's still up on the side of Summoner's Rift. It's on Yawara, obviously. And the push is still going strong. Tier 3 tower. This might be the last gasp for Complexity. I think they're trying to creep cut with Swindle. He's going to buy his Octarine Core, then maybe head back home. He's going to have to TP to do so. He's not going to creep cut. Naylor Racks in trouble. Glyph's still not there. Glyph's back on Swindle. He's all the way back at the secret shop. And now he has to think about maybe creep cutting. Do I go back? Do I walk back? It's going to be too late. The melee Rax is just done. LSA, so the fiery soul is there. They're going to walk in. Vacuum Wall only onto Demon. Yawara Song. He's going to try to just catch up Ziggs and snare him up and right click him down. And now you can see they have to break out the Song. Static Storm still goes. Ziggs will take the brunt of the damage. This won't kill him, but it'll be close. Glimmer Cave is going to keep him alive. They don't finish off the melee Rax. Instead, they find Swin on the backside. He won't have buyback. He just bought the Octarine Core. And that's it. That is GG! Oh, what was a great start for Complexity turns into multiple misplays, and Summer's Rift, who were definitely the underdogs in this series, take the first game of this best of three in surprising fashion. It is only game one, but God, Summer's Rift trounced them, man. It didn't look close after that 20-minute mark. They just held on, made sure, okay, we know what we have to do. Let's have Mike create space with the clockwork, which he did beautifully. And Whitebeard might be my MVP with the static storms that he hit. Just really solid team play coming up from Summer's Rift for Complexity. They got to change some things up. I'm not sure what it is, but after that 10-15 minute mark, they got to get something going. And that clearly wasn't it.